The traders are answering your questions now. First up, Marcia in Connecticut asks, what do I do with NXPI, Jim?
Well, look, I'm disappointed, as you probably are as well, that the merger with Qualcomm didn't go through. But here's the way to look at this. The damage is done. The stock is up about 12% from 2 years ago before the deal was announced. And in that time, the compound annual growth rate in revenue and earnings has been solidly in double digits. You're getting a great company at this price. If you own it, hang on to it.
All right, next up, Steph in Idaho wants to know, Joe, what's going on with Under Armour?
Well, Steph, since June 7th, it appears as though that really has been the high. I would avoid looking to buy this on a pullback. It clearly is pulling back. I would look at Nike. June 28th to June 29th, excellent earnings. Nike gaps higher. You're now pulling back into that gap. I want to be a buyer somewhere around $73, $74 for Nike. That's a better opportunity.
All right, one from Twitter, Weiss, from Mike, who asks, do you like AK Steel or U.S. Steel better ahead of earnings?
If I had to buy one, I'd buy U.S. Steel. AK Steel, I don't think the management's good, nor is the mix. You can make a very convincing story on buying both of these, however, if you believe tariffs are going to continue, because domestic production will win out over foreign production, and steel, of course, is a global commodity, but it makes it much more attractive. Although, I'm not sure I want to make that bet. So the stocks have bounced off the lows. To me, I don't like either one at this point in the cycle with the way rates are going.